Can I say something?
Yes.
Yes, most of his irritation really is my dealing with our kids, and mostly I'm more tent like sometimes I don't, when he asks me something, I don't remember most of the things that I do. Like, I'm more like in the state of unconsciousness. And my dealing with my, well, I'm kind of nervous, like, and I cannot really relate. I cannot really know how to relate to people. And when he wants to communicate with me, I just don't know how to express myself.
And you get upset.
Yes, because
you get frustrated.
Yes, I get frustrated because he tend to frustrate me.
Well, how does he do it?
Well, especially.
Is he a bad man? Be honest.
Yes.
Is he no damn good?
Well, he corrects me.
Let me ask you a question: Is he no damn good, or is something good in him?
He is good, something good in him, and
there is.
He loves God.
He loves what's right.
And yes, he loves what's right.
Is that why you want to stay with him? You wouldn't stay with him if he didn't have that quality, right?
That's right. That's why I stay with him, because
I recognize that quality in him. Very nice.
But my frustration is when he asks me questions for the things that I've done wrong, I seems like I cannot see it, especially in dealing with our children.
Such as correction.
Like, I fail to sometimes to correct my children, right? Well, I was not brought up myself. I don't really know how to be a mother.
Cause you don't? You do. You just forgotten. No, you do know. You just forgot. You just need to remember.
Well, I
you do know, because when you do it wrong, you feel guilty. So the right way is obviously still there inside you. Except it's not strong enough. What's stronger is the wrong way. Go ahead, though.
And when he sees things that my mistakes irritate him.
And do they irritate you? Does her mistakes irritate you?
Yes.
Well, at times it does, because she's.
Yes, you see the problem. This is the problem, and I'm not saying you can solve it in 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. But you see, you're two compulsive creatures. Interacting to each other. She hates all men, you hate women. Your hate makes lust, her hate makes her guilt, and makes up to that lust. See how that is? You have a lust which comes out of being an imperfect man.
Because I noticed also when he got angry, and then after that angriness, we tend to make love.
Right.
And then when we make love, it seems like I noticed that when we make love, he get worse.
Right.
And when we don't make love, you know, we get along good.
What was that again?
When we don't make love, we seems to get along better and seems to understand. But my problem
well,
is I just don't know how to communicate.
Diddly diddly do. When you don't make love,
seems like
you
our
get better.
Communication is much better.
Anybody noticed that before? Who's noticed that? That doesn't mean to say you don't have to make love and all the rest of it. You call it make love. That's a silly statement, isn't it? It's like you're inventing love, or is it originating love? Let's go make some. Let's go make some cookies. And then we'll go make some love. See, we've got the wrong words for that.
And I also, what he said.
But before you go any further, why do you think you get along better when you don't make love, as you call it?
Well, to me, it's a greater sense of respect.
Pardon?
It seems like a greater sense of respect for when we don't make love.
Say that again. I can hear.
It seems like a deeper sense of respect.
A deeper sense of respect when you don't. That's interesting, isn't it? That you should know that without anybody telling you. But if you think making love is respect, and most men demand such respect, you got problems. Because men then demand women to give respect. Well, if you prove it, then make love with me. If you love me, do your little thing. Right? So a woman resents that, but she feels guilty and goes along with it to be loved. But the only she gets rewarded for being a whore. She hates herself. And her husband doesn't become a better person because by supporting his weakness for her and responding to the pressure of going along with the animal is more of an animal. And there's a darkness on the end of the tunnel. There's no spiritual light.
You have been watching one in a series of programs recorded in Ventura, California, titled The Hypnosis.